Hi guys, Lauren from RC Benchmark here. Thanks for coming to part 3 of our database video series. Today I'm going to show you how to create an account, upload results, and compare test data in the database. So we'll click on over to register, and it takes fairly little information to create an account with us. You just need your name, your email address, and a password. So we'll enter that in here. And then you can click on register. You can confirm your email with the email link that was sent to you. And yep, fairly simple, just click verify email address and your account is verified. And then you can log in again. So once you're all logged in, and it'll take you back to the landing page for the database. And from here, if you want to upload data to the database, you actually have to go into the RC Benchmark software. So we'll open up our software here. The first thing you see when you open it is the safety agreement. So just go and click accept. And this brings us to the main page. We'll connect our test stand. And there we go. We can see the charts rolling. You can select which charts, real-time plots you want to see. Then we move on over to setup. We need to click activate experimental scripting mode. This setting is required to upload data to the database. Then we click on the database upload tab, and here we have the name of our test as well as the throttle points you want to cover. We go on in and click start, and then the test starts rolling. So it'll take us through all of the throttle points that we had input. And you'll see on the graphs at the bottom that the data is starting to come in real time. And then as soon as the test ends, it automatically opens up the RC Benchmark database with your test. So you just click on Add New Test. And then you can go ahead and enter motor data with the motor you used in the test. If you don't find it in the list, you can add your own. Same thing with propeller. You can check in the drop-down menu or add your own. So we'll put our info in there. And finally, the same thing with the ESC. And this is updating all your data live, so you don't have to hit save or anything when you're done. It's automatically updated. And so then we have all the information about this test that we completed, our components, our thrust stand information, the plots from our data, as well as our data table. Now the final thing I'm going to show you how to do today is how to compare results in the database. So let's say we clicked over to motors, and we wanted to look at the efficiency or properties of different propellers and ESCs with a given motor. So let's use this one, for example, the DYS Samguk Shu 2306. And from our previous videos, we know that this page includes all the tests done with this motor in our database. So we'll show the first 10 entries here. And to compare them, you just select all of those. And then right at the bottom, click on compare 10 selected in this case. And this will give you plots which include data for all the tests that we have clicked on. So we can look at rotation speed over time, we can look at thrust or torque versus rotation speed, voltage, current, and power properties. And finally down here, we can look at motor and ESC efficiency, propeller efficiency, and propulsion efficiency. If you hover over any of the data points, it'll give you the numbers associated with that data point, as well as the motor and propeller used. And so if we compare the propeller efficiency and propulsion system efficiency graphs, we can see that at lower rotation speeds, it is the HQ prop 5131 that is most efficient. But at almost all rotation speeds, the propulsion system that is most efficient uses the HQ prop 5040. So again, we see that it's not necessarily the efficiency of the individual components that's important. It really is the system overall. And using this compare feature can allow you to compare those systems and figure out which one is the most efficient for you. So that's all I'm going to show you. Thanks for watching our three-part video series on the database. If you have any questions remaining, feel free to leave us a comment or send us an email. We're always happy to talk to you guys. And if you have anything else you'd like to learn, let me know in the comments and maybe we'll add another video to this series. Thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.